Okay.
Nilo!
Nilo!
Getting up in levels. Yeah, full tilt, you're out of freaking mana. See me, buddy.
Come on, you guys.
Ready?
Whoa. Three guys are gonna, yeah. Oliver's getting close. Swain leveled up. Okay, so he's got 4 mana. Little sun crystal. Behind. Chloroboros. Up because we leveled. Cool.
What can I say? It's a gift.
It's a gift. Right, I know this is probably silly, but hey, you got 2 other little Thursday characters with you. Eric, it's time for you to go your final form, mate. I think we're going Iisa, right? That big old beard. Sea stars, thunderbolt. Yeah. Iisa! Look at this bushy beard it gets. Oh my god, look at you! Can we feed you anything? Accuracy, oh yes, let's boost that up by a fuck ton, please. Yes. Magical attack? No, that's not you. You don't have any magical. Cocoa bonbons? Yeah! You're very close to getting that full familiarity. Okay, we can't feed you anymore. Feed you though. Get some magical attack. go up anymore. Gregory? No, not Gregory. You get some more attack, mate. Yeah. Sound he makes. Yeah. Defense. Okay, no, that didn't increase your heart. But very much, you really do like attack. No? Not fan of any of these, by the looks of it. Hey, Ray. Big old Dargan. I mean, wasn't his favorite. Okay. Oh, that's the frog again. Nature tongue. Help me, please. Or help him, please. Okay, who we helping? Hang on, I get a bad feeling about this. Where are we? Mikey, this place is a bit blinking grim. Must be a prison or something. Is there someone there? The hell are you? Yeah, who's that? It's a flipping frog. Another one. Another one. You mean that it's to say that someone else has been blighted by my curse? Actually, we were cursed and turned into frogs ourselves. But we didn't look like you, though. Leave now. You must leave this place. It is dangerous. But you... Don't waste your time worrying about me. What's the matter? Are you hurt? Oh, look, we have to do something. Yes, we have to help him. I guess I can use magic to open this door. Let's give it a try. Ring lock. What are you doing? Leave me alone, I beseech you. Wait a minute, are you the Frog Prince? The who? You know who I am? But how? Frog Prince of the Desert. That's you, isn't it? The one who left his kingdom, abandoning his princess. How do you... What are you going on about, Esther? Are you trying to confuse us or something? Wouldn't take much to confuse the likes of you, Swain. Wow. I'm a bit shocked, I'm just a bit shocked, alright? Didn't think you were going to bump into a prince from a fairy tale, did I? Fairy tale? See, so that's how you know of me. Let me think. Yes, as I remember. Alright, listen carefully. Once upon a time, before the fathers of our fathers were born, in the kingdom lived a handsome and courageous young prince, who was much loved by all his subjects. Then one day, the kingdom was attacked by a serpent, a beast, a hideous that struck fear into all it saw, a terrible, evil creature. The prince decided, in order to defeat the serpent, he would have to drink a certain mysterious potion. No sooner he swallowed it than the diabolical draught had. Then he began to turn into a frog. What? Why would he drink a potion that turned him into a frog? A frog doesn't stand a chance against beating a snake. I haven't finished the story yet. I told you to listen carefully, didn't I? Not to ask stupid questions. Damn, Esther. Now, where was I? Oh yes, the reason he decided to turn into a frog was to lull the serpent into a false sense of security by becoming one of its favorite foodstuffs, if I recall correctly. Yes. My apologies, please continue. And then the prince turned himself into a frog, for he had a plan. knew the serpent would not be able to resist eating him, and though he would be allowed to attack the monster from within. The plan worked, the serpent swallowed the prince and received a mortal blow from inside. But alas, the prince did not return to his original form. No matter what he tried, he remained an ugly frog. The cursed thing caused him great disaster. He could not stand thinking of how foolish he'd been. So he worked to hide himself away from the world. Now, the prince was married to a beautiful young princess, though she had promised that they would be together forever and ever. She had not seen him since he left to face the serpent. It began to seem that he would never return. Despairing, the princess went to the tomb where the prince had slain the serpent and wept for her lost love. And she remained there, waiting for a prince, though she knew he would never come. Waiting until the end of her days... she waited, you say? I see, it's truly become a fairy tale. It's a pretty sad story. Every girl in Alma Moon is told this story when they're young, and everyone cries the first time they hear it. Because if this was a work of fiction. Sorry, Prince Ali. What, Alibaba? No, it's just Prince Ali. Prince Ali, fabulous he, Alibaba. Prince Ali. A long time since anyone's called me by my name. Well then, did I tell you the final chapter of your fairy tale? Final chapter? So the prince left his princess behind and turned back his back on his kingdom. Princess named Yasmina, Jasmine. By the way, she was the love of the prince's life, and yet he abandoned her. Many years passed and the prince remained a frog, only to find, to his dismay, that he was unable to die. Yes, he was destined to live as a frog forever, even after his kingdom had been razed to the ground. It's just terrible. I may have suffered, but it's nothing compared to the pain I caused my beloved Yasmina. Indeed, I feel sometimes that it is just punishment. But why are you in a cell, Your Highness? It's the serpent, Apep. He has returned, and we brought him back to life. I don't think many people would be able to breathe new life into an ancient monster. Yeah, I can only think of one. Shadar. Yeah. Pep wasted no time in taking his revenge. That is how I became imprisoned here. Who can say how long he intended to prolong my agony? How I have not suffered enough to remain in this form to live without my beloved. Oliver, isn't there a spell that we can... that we can cast to bring Prince Abi back to normal? You mean something to lift a curse that turned him into a frog? Hang on a flippy minute, man. Why don't we just use that magic circle that lifted our froggy curse? You're right. It worked for us, maybe it worked for him. But surely he did not consume the same shape-shifting potion that I did. Well, it wasn't a potion, no. That's not important right now. Come on, Your Highness, let's give that magic circle a try. Does such a magic truly reside in this temple? And what if I were to become human again? What new torments would a Pep devise for me then? Must be thinking about things like that. Minus, we have to try at least. Now come with us, we'll take you straight to the magic circle. Prince Ali, fabulous he, Ali Ababa. Strength stronger than 1,000 men. Man of the sea. He beat the galloping hordes. 100 banners with swords. Sorry, I just loved the original Aladdin with Robin Williams. So good! Where did the rainbow frog go? Oh! Looks like there's some runes. Yeah, that looks like, got something that looks like that. Yeah, that's a puppet string. There's no statues or anything. Oh, wait, are those the statues that we need to... Figure that one out in a bit. And so, Lee, this is a magic circle that lifted our curse. Magic circle? Could such a thing really have the same effect on me? Well, there's only one way to find out. Yes, you're right. What? You don't understand. He's standing on the magic circle just like we did, but nothing happening. Poor fellow's been like that for thousands of years. You were only cursed for a few minutes. I'm sorry, Prince Ali, I didn't mean to give you get your hopes up. There's no need to apologize. I was rather expecting this to happen. You don't believe my curse will be lifted while Abep draws breath. He's doubtlessly using his foul magic to strengthen its hold. Well then, it's pretty obvious what we have to do then, isn't it? That's right, Mr. Drippy. There's only one thing for it. I need to turn on that fan. It is getting stuffy in here. Hold on. Right, sorry about that. Ow. Switch some water because I need to get something down my throat. Surely not. Surely you're not going to try and defeat Adep or Pep. That would be unspeakably reckless. I shall assist you. I must. No, you can't fight him, Prince Ali. Not in your condition. Don't worry, Prince Ali. You can count on us. We'll defeat Adep and lift your curse. I believe you. Something about you makes me believe. That lurks deep within these ruins. I'll just take you to him. Okay. Perhaps a key is required to open that door, but there's no key in these ruins, I'm sure. However, there was something written on the wall of my cell. I wonder if it could be some kind of clue. Two firm friends play leapfrog all across the floor. But there was more as well, I'm sure. Perhaps understanding those words, need to open the door. Okay. Were these words? Oh. Something written on the wall up there. Friends play across the floor. Oh, and there's more. Each one gamely going where the other was before. Doesn't make so much sense to me, man. Frog across the floor. Hang on. Leapfrog person. The person that could be leapfrogging is me. No? Leapfrog across the floor. Each friend going where there was before. Okay. Where's freaking pop string? I am confusion. Pretty sure I fucked this one up. Yeah. They're both going where they were before. They would never stop moving in the same pattern. So. I'm doing it across the floor. Right. I need to go to the loo. So I'm gonna try and ponder on this one, and then I'll be back in a few moments. Please bear with me. Thank you. Right, I am back. Alright, let's try and reset this here, shall I? Did it lock in there? Okay, that's cool. Wait, what? What? I'm... okay. That's weird. Followed the instructions and yet the door remains closed, but I'm sure I heard some kind of noise. But the water level has lowered. We can get around now, but... okay. Each of them going with it. I mean, they started off there. So were they literally just meant to move from one side to the other? And I just happened to put them back in the wrong, yet right... okay, whatever. I'm not questioning. I'm not a question. Fuck that puzzle. Then what was the point of all the... whatever. Whatever, game. That's a bad circle there, I think. Yeah, because that doesn't look like the rest of them. I think if I touch that, I turn into a frog. That was a Nyx trap. I don't know what Nyxes do. Oh, there's a thing there. Open that, please. You obtain a set of storm what? Set of what now? Storm serpent scales. Trick type intensified. You. Oh wait, you're more light. Wait, no, that's just what your good defense is against. Yeah. You have a lot of these wind spells. Shortly. I still don't have a way to open up these chests. Yeah. Anything else that we can use to maybe open up chests? Insight? Nope. Huh. Oh, jump. Jump, be jump, be jump, be jump, jump. Oh, wait, hang on. But whatever we need is in that chest down there? But I can't open these chests. Oh wait, it's only a blue one. Well, it doesn't say potent magic. Oh, we can't cast spells at the moment because we've got... oh, so Nyx is a silence. Okay. We have some Nyx Begons, don't we? Don't we? Serpent key. Definitely can't open the purple one there. Mm-hmm. Right, so now we have a key for that door, I'm guessing. Let's go and quickly remove this Nyx